sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And having come in, the angel said to her, "Rejoice, highly favored one, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women." But when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and considered what manner of greeting this was. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb, and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He will be great, and will be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. And he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And his kingdom there will be no end." Then Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I do not know a man?" And the angel answered and said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Highest will overshadow you. Therefore also that Holy One who is to be born will be called the Son of God."
You are the morning star. You are the day star.
Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord showed around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you, you will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men."
Thank you.
For it was, when the angels had gone away from them into heaven, that the shepherds said to one another, Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. Now when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all those who heard it marveled at those things they had told by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, as it was told them. And when 8 days were completed for the circumcision of the child, his name was called Jesus, the name given by the angel before he was conceived in the womb.
Oh.
Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he who was born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him. When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. So they said to him, In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not the least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you shall come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel. Then Herod, when he had secretly called the wise men, determined from them what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, Go and search carefully for the young child, and when you have found him, bring back word to me, that I may come and worship him also. When they heard the king, they departed. And behold, the star which they had seen in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. And when they had come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. When they had opened their treasures, they presented gifts to him, gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
Thank you.
which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, did not consider it robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, taking the form of a servant, and coming in the likeness of men. And being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even the death of the cross. Therefore God has highly exalted him and given him the name which is above every name, that in the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of those in heaven and those on earth and of those under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
Joy, let there be hope, let there be light. How many of you are joyful tonight?
Amen.
I didn't hear me. I heard the choir. How many of you are joyful? We have the joy of the Lord. Amen. So before our pastor comes, we're going to do one more song. Let there be joy, let there be hope, let there be light.
Thank you.
choir, and just want to say a couple of things. The choir has sung about joy and the hope and the life that we have because Jesus came, and he is the reason that we have hope. And you know, that sounds strange to some people, and the whole gospel sounds strange sometimes, right? And we have to be reminded that we have a God who's our creator, and he's completely holy, right? He's perfect. He's without sin. He can't look upon sin, and yet we're sinners, right? And our sin separates us from God. And if that's all we had, we would be hopeless. Our sin deserves punishment. But if it weren't for Jesus, if it wasn't for his coming, if it wasn't the fact that he stepped out of heaven, right? Born of a virgin named Mary. He came and was born. He lived a sinless life. We know that he went to the cross. We know that on the cross he took our place. He died instead of us. He took the punishment that we deserve. And if not for the cross, we would be hopelessly lost in our sins. But the good news is, for God so loved the world, right? You all know John 3:16, that he sent his son. Paul said it like this in Galatians. He said, at just the right time, God sent forth his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those under the law. He was born with the purpose of redeeming us. And Paul says that Christ died according to the scriptures. He was buried, and on the third day, he rose again according to the scriptures. And so Christ came, right? And we celebrate that. We celebrate it tonight. We celebrate it during Christmas. We celebrate it all the time. Christ came, and we celebrate the fact that he died for our sins. He was resurrected from the grave, and he offers to save us. He offers us salvation. If we'll turn from our sins, if we'll put our hope and faith and trust in Jesus Christ, and listen, it's our hope. It's our prayers that your hope and trust and faith is in Jesus. And if not, we want to make ourselves available to speak to you about how to have faith and hope in Jesus Christ. And we want you to leave with the joy and hope that only comes through a relationship with Jesus Christ. And so join me in thanking the choir for reminding us of the hope and joy that we have in Christ. Thank you, Brother Nehemiah. I think he's left the building. Where's he going? Nehemiah, thank you, brother, for leading us. And we hope that, thank you. While you all are in the thanking business, we got Greg and Chris back there on the sound. Thank you guys for all the work that you all do. Thank you, Alan, for working his arms out with these lights. Thank you, children, for helping. Thank you, thank you. Hey, thank you all for coming. And I hope you'll gather in the morning to worship the Lord. I hope you have a church. If not, we'd love to invite you. And these guys and gals will do this again tomorrow night. If you know anybody that would be blessed, we invite you to invite them for us, if you will. All right, anything I need to announce? Anything? Y'all, pretty good looking group of choir. Like a bunch of angels up there, don't they? No. Especially that one. All right. Thank you all. Why don't you stand and maybe just join the hand of the person beside you, and we'll pray and bless the Lord. And Lord, we just want to thank you for the hope, for the joy, for the light, for the life, for everything that we have in Christ. Lord, we often pursue things of this world, but they pale in comparison to what we have in Christ. This eternal life, this hope of a future resurrection, a future glory, a future eternity with Christ. We thank you for that. Thank you that Jesus was born. Thank you for the Gospels that remind us of this miraculous conception that Mary had, and this amazing birth of Jesus, this humble beginning, this life that he lived without sin. Thank you for all the teachings that we have from Jesus. And just thank you for the way that he loved people and ministered to people. Thank you for what he taught and what he still teaches us today through the Word. Thank you for his willingness to step out of heaven. Thank you for his willingness to endure the suffering of the cross, die in our place. Thank you for that. Lord, we think about it. We think how undeserving we are. But then we're filled with gratitude that you'd be willing to do that. You'd be willing to allow your son to come. You'd be willing to allow him to suffer and die in our place. Thank you, Jesus, that you were willing to endure that for our sakes. We thank you that that tomb is empty, that Christ is raised, that salvation is available. And tonight we're not ashamed of the gospel because we know it's the power to save all, rich and poor, all around the world. It's the power that offers salvation, that brings hope, that we celebrate it tonight. We rejoice in it tonight. We thank you for the riches that we have in Christ. We thank you for the inheritance that we have. Thank you for that great reminder. May we pour out our lives to shine the light of Christ, to make him known. In Christmas time and throughout the season, throughout the year, may we give our lives for the sake of Christ. And a special thanks, Father, for our choir, and Brother Nehemiah, and all the ones who have worked for this. You know, we don't see it as a performance. We see it as this worship to you because you are worthy, because you gave your all that we might have life. Thank you again tonight for those who have gathered, and we pray that they have their faith and hope, trust, they have everything in Christ, and they leave tonight with the hope that comes only through their relationship with Jesus Christ. May you be glorified in our lives tonight. In Jesus' name, amen.
I don't know. What difference, baby?